Welcome back to Return to Pueblo Croix, a Story of Seasons fairy tale. We were heading back to the farm, I guess to check out the shipping box now, because it's like unlocked or something. So, we're going to be doing that. But first, I wanted to announce the winner of the Return to Pueblo Croix 3DS digital copy as soon as I kick this guy's butt. Ah. What the heck even is that? Man, no, let's do magic. Magic. Magic! Nice. Good job, Pietro. Blue's getting close to leveling up. Soon. But, anyway, I wanted to announce the winner. And that is Samantha Lewis. So thank you so much, everyone who entered. I have emailed you, Samantha. I just need you to get back to me to make sure that you are accepting your prize and everything's all good. So if you just want to email me back, I will get the code to you. And you can start playing Return to Pueblo Croix, which is great. I highly recommend it. Obviously. Am I going the correct way? Probably not. But yes. Okay. So here is the shipping box. Is that the only thing I have to ship? Yeah, I guess I don't have any turnips because I gave them away. And I think I sold one of them, so. But we can plant a new seed. A new turnip, right there. And then we'll plant some bitter spinach. Which is just funny. Alright. Water, there we go. Here. This is very basic farming, obviously. This is just sort of a side thing that you can do. It's not really the main focus of this game. But, it's a nice little inclusion. What's in here? Was this the barn? Yeah. We don't have any animals, so we don't really need that. Oh, I see I have a little flag. Okay, I guess we'll stay the night. I have a little objective flag here on the farm. Well, isn't that cute? Pietro doesn't like beds for some reason. Sure, we totally accomplished a lot, so saving is definitely something we need to be doing. What the heck? Is he having a vision? Who's that?
Come to me, O Prince of Light, from world beyond our darkened sight, a timely savior, bold and true. Galariel of Light I am, in humble service to this land, this road of light I bear to you. Your fate is to free the four by Flambius's flames rekindled shore. Awake my might to shine above. Through labyrinth and through cavern deep, the blessings of the earth to reap, a light once more this land I love.
What a strange song. I wonder what it means.
Well, you could listen to the lyrics, Pietro. She wants you to find some four people to save the world. That's what I got from it. That was the summary of that song. Beautiful. She kind of looked like Marmella, though. She had the ice cream hair. Know what I'm saying? Rawr.
Oh, I had a really weird dream, and I couldn't sleep too well afterward.
Rawr.
What was it? Well, there was a strange woman who appeared before me and started kind of singing.
Blue's like, what the heck, Pietro? Don't be dreaming of other women. Because we know it's Narsha. Come on, it's gotta be Narsha. Barf.
I couldn't see her face, but she did say her name. What was it again?
Galariel!
Yeah, that's it. That's exactly what it was. Whoa, Connie, do you know that person?
You bet I do. I know her really well, in fact, because I work for her. She's the person I serve under. Lady Galariel watches over all of Galariland and brings abundance to the world.
Oh, okay. Well, she sang something else, too. A whole little poem. She said, Galariel of Light I am, I think? Yeah, it was something like, Galariel of Light I am, in humble service to this land. This road of light I bear to you.
Oh, that's her, all right. That was surely a prophecy from Lady Galariel, a divine message just for our hero.
If that's the case, then can you tell me what she means when she says, this road of light I bear to you? Is that...
Uh-huh. It's Galariel's ability to create a bridge between worlds. She can manifest transport circles with her magic.
Between worlds? So, could I use that to return to Popolocroyce?
Yay, the title of the game.
Well, sure, but Lady Galariel would have to be revived first. Right now, her power has all been sucked away by Gryphit, so all she can do is appear to people in their dreams, like Freddy Krueger. Oh, poor Lady Galariel, so long-suffering, so pitiable. Woe is she, woe I say.
I'm remembering a little more of what she said, I think. It was something like, your fate it is to free the four by Flambius's flames rekindled shore. Awake my might to shine above.
Oh, I see, I understand. To revive Lady Galariel, you need to just do as she said. You need to free the four regions of Galariland from darkness. Which won't be an easy task by any means, since Gryphit's darkness runs really deep. But you can do it, Mr. Hero. I believe in you. So what do you say? Will you help bring about the resurrection of Lady Galariel, please? Take your time and think it over. I'll wait however long it takes to hear your answer.
That fairy is dramatic AF, man. Amelia seems to be missing you. Oh, my woman. I must go. Come on, other woman, let's go. Oh, I guess I should tell her my answer. Why was this even a thing? Why didn't he just say, yeah, I'll do it? Because we know he's going to do it because it's Pietro. So, whatever.
Mr. Hero, have you decided? Have you determined in your heart of hearts what it is you want to do? Will you help bring about the resurrection of Lady Galariel?
I can't. I have other shit to do.
I will, I guess. I want to get back to Popolocroyce, no matter what it takes. There are people there who need my help, and people here who need it too.
Rarf.
Oh, Mr. Hero! Mr. Hero! I've never been so happy before! From now on, I'll stay by your side through thick and thin. I'll be your traveling companion to the bitter end.
Do we really need to talk about the possibility of death here? Not very uplifting.
Thanks, Connie. I'd like that very
Whoa. Just hold on a minute. How can you be so naive?
Rarf.
Nino, what are you doing here?
Rue is just, that's not important right now. What is important is that you're being real stupid, Pietro. This is some random fairy and you're hanging on her every word, falling right into her trap.
Some random fairy? Are you talking about me? Well, I never. I am of the noble order of Galari Sprites and a direct servant of Lady Galariel herself. I'll have you know.
That's ridiculous. I ain't buying that bull for a second.
I'll show you, bull.
Pietro, didn't you just get burned by trusting a complete stranger, like, earlier this week? Isn't that how you got here in the first place? So why the heck are you so eager to start trusting this fairy now? Ain't you never heard of a little thing called regret?
The person who tricked Mr. Hero was a servant of the Dark Lord Gryphit. How dare you lump me in the same category?
Why wouldn't I? Anytime someone's got something to say that sounds too good to be true, probably is. You're a fairy attached to a plot of land that's half dead. What proof do you have that you are who you say you are? I ain't seen anything so special. Word of advice, Pietro? If you want to make a living for yourself here, you can't trust nobody but yourself and your closest pals. There are flim-flam artists all over Galerland and people who'll use you to get what they want. You go around trusting everybody, you're gonna get hurt.
No, I believe her.
What?
Sometimes you just have to believe in others, or nothing good can happen. So even if I'm being duped, I won't have any regrets. I'm not just going to give up and stay here forever. I'm determined to keep on moving and doing whatever I can. Wherever there's hope, I'll continue to cling to that hope. Even if it's really faint, I'll still hang on to it with all my strength.
Heck's wrong with you? Here I am giving you some great advice, and you're just gonna go with your gut instead? You're a total lost cause, man. Whoa, I ain't gonna hit him, I swear. No need to get so mad. See, we're good.
Mr. Hero, thanks so much for your faith. I'll make sure I don't let you down. Now, let's go into Urbane Forest. There's something along the road to Lampling that I think you should see.
Is it a hottie with a body?
Huh? What was between here and Lampling? Well, I guess we're about to find out.
Ralph.
Hey, why is the Killjoy following us?
Well, Pietro's an acquaintance. Yeah, I figure I might as well keep him company for a little. He should be grateful to have me around. Besides, even if he's willing to put his faith in your crazy stories, I sure as heck ain't gonna just sit back and let him get played for a fool again.
Oh, no. Nobody asked you to come, and nobody wants you to come, right, Mr. Hero?
Thank you, Nino. I'll feel a lot stronger with you by my side.
What?
Barf. Gonna be fun fighting with you, Wolfie. Don't suppose you'll let me pet you now, though, will you?
If Mr. Hero says so, then I guess you're coming with us. But let the record show that I do not approve of this.
Connie and Nino have joined the party. Well, our party just got, like, gigantic. Holy crap. Anybody else think Nino has a serious crush on Pietro? Just seems like it. New pair of skills available for Pietro and Nino. Pair of skills. Okay. Whoops. I did not mean to go back here. Okay. Let's see. He has combat knuckles, a lightweight stole, casual footwear, and a simple metal. He's a level 10. Dang. Equip. No, his defense would go down if I took the lightweight stole. Casual footwear. Gives him more speed. And a simple metal. Also gives him speed. I guess we'll keep all that stuff for him. Okay. So, I guess we gotta keep going this way, I think, and see what happens. I am not afraid of you. I have Nino now. Let's see what he just punches him in the face? That's awesome. That would be me if I were an RPG character. I'd probably just punch people. Actually, I usually play a mage if I have the choice. Of, like, a class. I'm almost always the mage. So I like magic. Alright. Ooh, chest. What do we have here? Energy badge. Huh. That would give me more magic and more defense, so I'm gonna equip that. Sorry, Pietro, I'm taking your prince badge. Sorry!
The gate is completely overgrown with black vines. There's no way through.
What about the fairy? Can't she magic it away? I thought we were supposed to go this way. Were we not supposed to go this way? Alright, punch him. Punch him, Nino. Punch him in the face. Oh my gosh, did you see that freaking... whatever it was? Vegetable. Did you see that vegetable's face when Nino came up and punched him? Oh man, I couldn't get close enough. Oh, don't get that crit. I'm gonna punch you. Yeah. Man, Nino's tough. I mean, I know he's like two levels above the rest of us, but still. He, like, kicks butt. Glad to have him on the team. Plus, I just think it's hilarious that he punches things. It is quite funny. What in the crap is that? Look at this thing. Ew. Oh, good one, Blue. Oh man, those crits. Treant. Kind of sounds like a Pokemon. Oh my gosh, this thing's tough. Let's try a skill. How about barrage? Alright. Oh my gosh. Nice. Good job, Nino. And Blue leveled up to level 8. So good for her. Good job, Blue. I have not been grinding at all. So I wonder if that's gonna bite me in the butt later. I don't know. It may not, because it's a simpler RPG, so might not have as much of a need for grinding. I don't know. Should we talk to Rue? Does he even know that you, like, left?
Rue, what are you doing? The earth and the water. Gotta be just right temperature. Is he alright, Nino? He seems totally lost in that field.
Eh, he's always like that. Whenever he starts farming, it's like he tunes out the world around him.
Aha! I'll bet you feel really lonely when he does that, too. Because without your dear little brother, nobody pays you any attention at all.
What? No, that's stupid. You trying to pick a fight with me or something?
Oh, ho, 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 ho. I do believe I hit the nail right on its big, bulbous, stupid head.
You guys need to shut up. Just saying. Can I steal more stew? No. I tried. But we can do this. Man, it's just crap. What's this? Oh yeah, I need a net or something. Fine. We'll go this way. I swore she said we were supposed to go to the South Urbane Forest, but maybe I was, like, not paying attention. Probably. Oh, we're supposed to go here. Well, why couldn't she unmagic the other door?
We're here. This is what I wanted to show you. Urbane Forest's famous Farm of Light. Mr. Hero, do you still remember what Lady Galariel told you in your dream?
You mean, your fate is to free the four by Flambius's flames rekindled shore? Awake my might to shine above?
That's right. This is one of the four. One of the lands sealed by darkness. It's known as the Sylvan Farm.
So I need to free this place from Greifit's influence, then?
Exactly. Only problem is, you can't get in through the front gate here on account of these dark vines. Boo.
Angry Spaghetti.
What? What's with the long faces?
If we can't get in, then why the heck do you lead us here? Ain't there any other entrances?
Oh, of course. There's one other way inside.
Oh my gosh, Pumpkin Man, you creepin'. Look at him creepin'.
To get to it, though, we'll have to work our way through the maze like mountain ruins.
Mountain ruins? You mean like that old building top of Mount Urbane?
That's the one. Somewhere inside those winding ruins, there's a means of getting to the other side of this door. And no one knows more about the ruins than the mayor of Matthew Village. So let's get ourselves up the mountain and pay her a visit.
I don't know if I'm saying that right.
Sounds like a pain in the rump to me. The monsters are real tough on the mountain too, and, guys? Who or what is that?
What in the world?
Pietro, you know this guy?
Oh, Mr. Pumpkin Man.
Well, if it isn't the nice young man who gave me a turnip and saved my life, fancy meeting you here. I was just out for a nice stroll when I happened upon you here. What an amazing coincidence.
This couldn't have been more intentional.
He was very clearly waiting here.
Did I hear someone say something about strong monsters? 'Cause that sounds like it could be a real problem.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I may not look it, but I'm actually a pretty good fighter. Dunno if you'd want me joining you, but I'd love to if you'll have me.
Sorry, we're full up. No, come along, Pumpkin Man.
Oh yeah, you just leave the bad guys to me. To be honest, I can't stop thinking about how happy I was when you gave me that turnip.
Man, he has a serious love of turnips.
Even with no knowledge of who I am or where I'm from, you swept in and showed pity on this poor old pumpkin. So I really like you, and I feel like I know you really well. It's almost like we've met somewhere before.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we have. But either way, my name is Pietro. It's very nice to, meet you.
Pietro, huh? That's a real nice name. And I'm gonna do what I can to pay you back for your good deed, Pietro. I am at your service.
Pumpkin Man!
Has joined the party. Wow, our party's getting gigantic.
Man, Pietro, seems like all the weirdos are attracted to you like flies to honey.
They sure are. People like, oh, I don't know, a stubborn, bullheaded little boy.
Or how about a chittering fairy that popped out of a half-dead farm?
They're gonna end up lovers, aren't they? Barf.
That's right. We don't have time to stand here and argue. We need to get to Matthew Village on the double and ask about the mountain ruin.
To get there, we just gotta follow the mountain path along the river east of here and keep on climbing. So what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Tiny Farm has produce to pick. Tiny Farm has thirsty produce. Well, I think I'm gonna end this episode here. I think I'll probably just head down and pick some of the turnips or whatever and water some of them. And then in the next one, we will, I guess, head to that mountain. See what our new party members are capable of. So, thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know how you're liking the series in the comments. And I will see you in the next video.